Hey, today you missed the lecture, you know?
Which one?
The cell biology one?
Absolutely.
You have missed the lecture on ribosome and Wedberg unit.
So what can I do?
Yeah, I have a solution for it. I have subscribed to the channel Biology the Brain Buffer, and I can get all the videos on ribosome and Wedberg unit.
Good morning, friends. Welcome back to another very short video tutorials from the Biology Brain Buffer. Let's grow together. In this particular video lecture, we shall be talking about the ribosome, an organelle that you are studying from class 9th, and the Wedberg unit concept. So let's come to the thing. So after this lecture, you will be able to answer the following question. First, what is ribosome and the discovery of it? So if I take the color, so you shall be capable to answer these things. Nobel work, importance and function other than protein synthesis, the concept of Wedberg unit, and why 50S plus 30S is not going to 70S, and finally the components and antibiotic effects. So these are the domain you can answer after the discussion. Let's come to the first thing. You know, in 1953, George Faraday discovered this particular organelles by centrifugation, separation. So he found that it is not membrane bound organelles, and it is composed of two basic things. As you know, the name says it is a ribosome. So it comprises ribonucleic acid, so mainly the nucleic acid, and the different types of proteins. So these are the different components of it. Now, if you homogenate the cell, if you have a cell and if you try to homogenate it, and you will get the sediment through it. So you can see, if you centrifuge in 1000 G within 10 minutes, you will get the tissue homogenate. Those are the very large component. And in the pellet, you can have the nucleus, cytoskeleton, plasma membrane. So if you change and increase the rate of like a centrifugation speed, 2000, 20,000, like that, and after 80,000 G, so if you keep increasing, you will get the mitochondria, lysosome, peroxisomes, like that. And finally, if you go further, 150,000 G, so after 3 hours, you can have the ribosome in the pellet. So that is why it indicates it is coming with the other biomolecules. So it's too small and it is composed of RNA and protein. So this 150,000 G means the speed should be very high in the centrifugal machine so that you can isolate it. Now, you know, in the 2009, Nobel Prize was awarded to the Venkatraman Ramakrishnan. He was a South Indian biophysicist, and Stace and Yona. So they basically studied the ribosome at the atomic level. So simply from the school days, we are studying ribosome as the protein factory. But they studied the structure and function of ribosome at the atomic level. For that, they awarded Nobel Prize. Now, you can see the structure and figure. So that is what the decipher at the atomic level. So they gave the electron density map of the ribosome, and this density atomic structure of the ribosome help the different binding of different factor like antibiotics and other releasing factor. So how this particular molecule, this ribosome machine, interact with the other component of the cell at the subcellular level. So you can see the animation, the nucleus is here, and close to that you have a endoplasmic reticulum, and you know the rough endoplasmic reticulum that is connected with the ribosome. So they help in the protein synthesis. But remember, ribosome is not only important for protein synthesis, they are having another function that we shall be talking about. They are like the enzymes. So now, first we have to understand that if you study the structure of a ribosome, so they have two different components and unit. One is the 30S and another one is a 50S. But the question is that if you sum those things, it is not going to be 80S. Instead of that, you are going to have a 70S. So we have to understand the meaning of S. So when you add 30S and 50S, it is not just algebraic sum. So mathematically, it will not be 80S. Rather, it is the unit of time. If you understand logically, it is just an unit of time. So if you add these two things, the centrifugation process leads to the decreased value of this S. So what is the sedimentation coefficient? It is a centrifugation separate particles, the suspension based on the different size, shape, and the density together define their sedimentation coefficient. It is like this, like you have a test tube and you have a ribosome in it. So when these ribosomes are connected with each other, you can see there are only two surfaces that is exposed to the environment if you take the upper surface and lower surface. Now if you separate these two surface, two component, small and large, you can see there more than two surface, that is upper surface and lower surface for the small subunit and upper and lower surface for the large subunit. So you have now four different subunits in place of two. So what you can see when you separate these two units, you are having more than two units. So four subunits, and important, you can see the surface area has got increased. That is why when you join these two particles, due to the you can see this part. So when you join these two small and large subunit, the surface area get reduced. Due to that reduction, and what is the amount of that reduction? That is around 10 S. So first we understand the meaning of S. It is just a sedimentation coefficient. When you sediment it around 1 lakh g, so you have an equation dr by dt into 1 by omega square r. So you have a chapter in physics, rotational motion. So you can understand that one in a very clear way. In biology, we have to understand that this Wedderburg unit is just an expression of time. So if you, I cannot, perhaps you cannot see this one. This is 10 to the power minus 13 second. So what does it mean? Like from class 9th, you are studying 60 years, 80 years, whatever. If I say 60 years, it means 60 into 10 to the power minus 13 second. So this is the time that is being taken by that particular organelle to get sedimented. So that is how when you join these two, like this small is 30S and this bigger one is a 50S. Together when you try to sediment it, as the surface area get decreased, because this part is decreased. So when you open it up, the surface area got increased. Now it is in the solution. So as you know, this is in the solution. So when these two particles are falling in the solution, the rate of friction will be increased. That is how, what will happen in like a, in a separation, in separate mode, they are having more subunit, more Wedderburg unit. So the equation indicate S is dependent upon the molecular weight, density and frictional coefficient. So more the surface area, more there is a friction. Now, if you study the prokaryotic ribosome and eukaryotic ribosome, is as possible as short period of time, you can see it is just a clump of RNA and some proteins. So you can see here there are 23S ribosomal RNA in the prokaryotic structure and 5S and 35 different types of proteins. 35 is the number that says different types of protein. Now 5S means 5 into 10 to the power minus 13, 23S like 23 into 10 to the power minus 13 second. But 23S RNA is very important, and it act as an enzyme. This is the unique in biological system. So there is a question that normally comes, name one enzyme that is not a protein. So that is the 23S ribosomal RNA molecule that itself act as a protein. On the other hand, if you study the eukaryotic ribosome, that is the combination of 60S and 40S. So again, it is not equal to 100S, as it is not an algebraic sum. So you will get the 80S in whole. So 60S is the big unit with 49 proteins and 5S ribosomal RNA and 5.8S RNA. This is the, these are the structures. Similarly, you can see this picture also, small yellow, this curve denote the ribonucleic acid, and they do not have any membrane that can cover it. The biogenesis and the origin of ribosome is still very complex and problematic. Some scientists believe that in the nucleus, there is a nucleus and nucleolus. So the possible origin of ribosome is nucleolus, through which this clump of proteins and ribosome get synthesized. So point to be noted, other than protein synthesis, they have a function called enzymatic function, and that is executed by 23S ribosomal RNA. You can reduce the speed of the video if I am going very fast. Now you can see there are different types of proteins, total 31 protein in the bacterial cells or eukaryotic structure, and 23S RNTs means ribonucleotides. So you have a detailed number, 2900. So Venkatraman, they all studied all the things in details. Now this is how the things actually should be deciphered. Now you can see the four surface that is exposed, and two surface that is exposed. Correct. And another, there is a structure of tRNA. This is the structure of tRNA. This tRNA interact with the ribosome. In future video, we shall be talking about that. And in vertebrates, eukaryotic cell, you can see the number of proteins is little bit more than the prokaryotic structure, 50 and 33. So around 83. So now if I go to the next slide, so these are all the research output from those worker. So they found if you have a bacteria and like you have a 30S unit, so definitely it is from prokaryotic bacteria. And when you apply antibiotic to that, they have found different types of antibiotic interact with the different domain of the ribosome. So like a pactomycin, different tetracycline. So different antibiotic interact with the ribosome. And what they does, see the box on the left region of the 30S subunit where the micro messenger RNA and tRNA ligand binds. These are the interaction sites. And that, as can be seen in the expansion of the box, and is also key antibiotic bind to the sites and causes loss of ribosome function. So the moment in the bacteria, the ribosome loss its functioning, the protein synthesis will be instantly blocked. So the bacteria cannot survive in that situation. So slowly they will start degrading and on the verge of death. So now again, you have a little bit details on structure and like you have a different domain in which you can see like a pink color. This pink donates the interaction site of our antibiotic, as you can see, like streptomycin. So after the application of the streptomycin, they can see the dark pink region. So this is how the entire thing, you know, the simply the ribosome is a protein factory. So they interact with the messenger RNA along with the tRNA, and finally they create the protein in a step-by-step manner. So that is a different topic translation. But if you simply apply antibiotic, previously it was not known to the scientist how exactly protein is being blocked if you apply antibiotic to the bacteria or those prokaryotic cells. So they have discovered different domains and different regions. So you can read this article. I have taken this picture from the original lecture of Venkatraman. So now you can see the different part have a different color code that denotes all different antibiotics are having different interaction site with the ribosome, and that mutation they have named as a RAM mutation. So RAM mutation causes the loss of function of ribosome. As a consequence, the bacteria will die as it cannot synthesize proteins, because proteins cannot be synthesized means enzyme cannot be synthesized. So for to run a simplest biological reaction, you need enzyme. So simplest biological reaction will be stopped at that moment. That is how the bacteria will lose its activity or life cycle. So this is what the thing that we want to discuss today. If you want to share, you can share with your friends. You can subscribe for free. Link, you can like and comment. And most importantly, if you have any problem regarding any questions, you can post me in the comment section. I will try to make a video on that one. Till then, thank you so much for your attention. Have a good day.